Good morning, all of you. This is chapter 9, compound interest, introduction portion. Today we are going to study about compound interest, and we have to see the basic terms which we are using in this compound interest. So first of all, this is an introduction video. Here you are going to study about all the formulas which we are going to study in this chapter, and plus the basic terms which will be very useful while solving this chapter. So the first one is principal. Principal here in compound interest means the amount of money borrowed or invested. Means suppose you are the amount of money borrowed or invested. Suppose you are opening a school only. So either you will invest on it or either you will borrowed on it. So the amount of money which you are going to invest on opening the school or you are going to borrow it, that is the principal here. Now what is the interest here? Interest means it is the additional money paid to the lender for the money he borrowed. Suppose you have borrowed rupees, let's take an example, just an example. Suppose you have borrowed rupees 1000 from me. Okay, so what it is the additional money paid to the lender for the money you borrowed. Okay, so I said, okay, I will give you 1000 rupees, but after 1 week you have to give me 100 rupees extra for that. Okay, so how much interest you have to pay to me for 1 week? You have to pay 1000 plus 100, means 1000 plus 100, that is 1100 rupees you have to pay to me as an interest. Okay, because the additional money you have borrowed from me is 1000, and the interest which you have to give it to me, that is 100 rupees after a week. So total money which you will give me, that is 1100 rupees. So this is the interest. Now what is rate? Interest rate, interest for 1 year per rupees. Okay, rate is interest for 1 year is how much? Rupees 100. What is time here? Time means the time period for which the money is borrowed. Like suppose I have taken this example, that you have borrowed 1000 rupees from me, and after 1 week you will give me 100 rupees extra. Mean 100 rupees you will pay me extra, so total amount you will give to me, like this is 1100 rupees. So similarly, the time period for this was how much? 1 week, that means 7 days. Similarly, I can say it for 1 year, half year, 2 years, 3 years, 2.5 years, 5 years, 10 years. That is the time period. The time period for which the money is borrowed. Okay. Now the last is simple interest. Now what is simple interest? When interest is paid to the lender regularly every year or every half year on the same principal, means every year, suppose you have borrowed rupees 10,000 from me. So for this, you have to pay interest. When interest is paid to the lender regularly, means every half, every year or every half year, you have to pay interest to me on the same principal. Same principal means this much only. So that is what simple interest.
So as we have studied what is principal rate, simple interest, time period, now we are going to study the formula. Now we are going to study the big formula which is going to be used in this chapter. Okay. So first we are going to study the formula for simple interest. Simple interest, it is represented by SI, and this will be equal to P into R into T upon 100. Simple interest, it will be equal to P into R into T upon 100, where P is the principal, R is the rate, and T is the time period. So what is the formula for simple interest? Find out simple interest is P into R into T by 100. So this is the formula for simple interest. From here, if you are given to find out the principal here, then how you will find out? So from this formula only it will be derived. Simple interest, it will be equal to simple interest into 100 will be equal to P into R into T. Okay, similarly what you have to find out, you have to find out the principal. So that will be equal to simple interest into 100 equal to P. If these are in multiplication, this will come in division. So then you have to find out the principal. The formula will be simple interest into 100 upon R into T. Then the principal will be there. Similarly, when you have to find out the pay, so what will be the formula? It will be simple interest into 100. What is left? If from here, if I will take out the, if I take rate, what will be left? P and T. So P and T will be, it will come down. So this is the formula for finding out the rate. When you have to find out the principal, rate and time will be down. When you have to find out the rate, principal and time will be down. So when you have to find out the time, what will be the formula? So for when you have to find out the time means T. T will be equal to simple interest into 100 upon what is left? P into R. So P into R. So these are the basic formula which we are going to use. If you have to find out the simple interest will to P into R into T by 100. With this formula only we have derived the formula for principal, that is simple interest into 100 upon R into T. Similarly, for rate is equal to simple interest into 100 upon P into T. Similarly, for time it is simple interest into 100 upon P into R. Okay. Now, how question will be coming in this chapter? Like first question I am taking, find the simple interest. Find the simple interest. You have to find out the simple interest when principal it is given 10,000. Okay, rate will be given 5%. And time it is given, suppose it is 2 years. Okay, now what you have to find out, you have to find out the simple interest here. So formula for simple interest is P into R into T by 100. You just need to substitute the values. What is principal here? 10,000. What is R here? 5. And what is time given to you is 2 years. Okay, divided by 100. So this zero gets cancelled. This zero gets cancelled. This is 100. 5 2s are 10. Okay. So this is 1,000 rupees. So what is the simple interest? Simple interest is 1,000 rupees. Similarly, this will be changed, like it you will be given with simple interest, principal, rate and time. You have to find out the principal. Similarly, the question will change. You will be given with the rate. You will be given with simple interest, principal and time. You have to find out the rate. Like I have given different formulas for finding out time, rate and principal and simple interest. So accordingly you have to understand that which formula we have to use. Now, how question will be coming in this chapter? Like first question I am taking, find the simple interest. Find the simple interest. You have to find out the simple interest when principal it is given 10,000. Okay, rate will be given 5%. And time it is given, suppose it is 2 years. Okay, now what you have to find out, you have to find out the simple interest here. So formula for simple interest is P into R into T by 100. You just need to substitute the values. What is principal here? 10,000. What is R here? 5. And what is time given to you is 2 years. Okay? Divided by 100. So this 0 gets cancelled, this 0 and this 0 gets cancelled. This is 100. 5 twos are 10. So this is 1000 rupees. So what is the simple interest? Simple interest is 1000 rupees. Similarly, this will be changed. Like it, you will be given with simple interest, principal, rate and time. You have to find out the principal. Similarly, the question will change. You will be given with the rate. You will be given with simple interest, principal and time. You have to find out the rate. Like I have given different formulas for finding out time, rate and principal and simple interest. So accordingly you have to understand that which formula we have to use. When you are going to find out the compound interest is equal to amount minus principal. Okay, so CI, I can write down this amount minus principal. For this you have to find out what is the formula for amount. So amount equal to principal 1 plus R upon 100 to the power n. This is the formula for amount. Principal is equal to 1 plus R upon 100 to the power n. So then you have to find out the compound interest. Compound interest is equal to amount minus principal. What is amount? This is amount minus principal. Amount is given P into 1 plus R upon 100 to the power N. And what you have to subtract? You have to subtract principal minus P. Okay? So from here, if I take P common, what will be 1 plus R upon 100 to the power N minus 1. This is the formula for simple interest. You can use either this or this. So this is the formula for compound interest and this is the formula for amount. In this question, we will study compound interest when interest is compounded annually. Okay, this is the first point. When interest is compounded annually, what you have to find? You have to find the amount and you have to find out the compound interest on the rupees 5000. So here, for 2 years and 10% rate, interest being payable yearly. So we have to find the amount and we have to find out the compound interest. Okay, what is given to you is on rupees 5000. So 5000 here is your principal for 2 years. 2 years is your time, that is 2 years. And 10%. So 10% here is the rate. What you have to find out? First you have to find out the amount. You know that compound interest is equal to principal minus amount. Compound interest is equal to principal minus amount. You are given with compound interest equal to principal minus amount. So finding out the compound interest, first you have to find out the amount here. So amount is equal to 1 plus R upon 100 to the power n. Okay, you are given with the formula for amount is 1 plus R upon 100 to the power n. Here R is the rate, N is the time period. Okay, so with this you can find out the amount. Amount is equal to, sorry, P into 1 plus R upon 100 to the power N. So P is the principal here. Okay, P is the principal here. So what is the principal given to you is 5000 upon 1 plus R. What is R given? Rate is
So solve this. This 0 and this 0 will get cancelled. You will be remaining with amount is equal to 5000 into, if you take the LCM, it will be 10. So 10 plus 1 is 11 upon 11 by 10 whole square. So this will be 5000 into 11 by 10 into 11 by 10. This 0 and this 0 gets cancelled. This 0 and this 0 will get cancelled. When you will multiply this, you will get 6050 as the amount. Okay. Now what is, you have to find out the compound interest. So how you will find out the compound interest? Compound interest equal to principal minus amount.
Compound interest here it will be, instead of P minus A, it is amount minus principal. From the amount you have to subtract the principal. So amount minus principal is, what is the amount here? You got 6050. So 6050 is the amount. What is the principal here? It is 5000. So subtract this, you will get 1050 as the amount. As the compound interest. So in this question, what is given? It is given when interest is compounded annually, means it is yearly. See, two years it is given, 1 year it will be, it can be 5 years, it can be 10 years. So in this way, you have to find the amount and compound it. This is the next portion, when compound interest is compounded half yearly. So what changes are there when we find out the compound interest is half yearly? So if the interest is paid half yearly, okay, so the rate will be divided by 2, okay, because it is for half yearly. So the rate will be divided by 2, okay, that is R by 2. Similarly, when we have to take out the time, suppose the time is n, so it will be multiplied by 2, so it will become 2 into 10, because 2n is every 6 months, so 2 times the time will be calculated. So here in the compound interest, we will divide the rate by 2n in time, we will multiply the time into 2. Suppose in the first question, what was given? Principal was given 10,000, rate was given 5, and time was given for 2 years. Okay, this was the question in the previous question. So what we have to do, if we have to compound it half yearly, so this rate will become 5 by 2%, and the time will be multiplied. So this will become 2. That is for 4 years you have to find out. Rest everything will be the same. Only these things you have to remember, that rate will be divided by 2 and time will be multiplied by 2. In the condition of when you have to calculate by compounded half yearly. This is when the rate of interest for successive years are different. That means rate of interest are R1, R2 and R3. And for the successive year means, for the first year it will be R1, for the second year it will be R2, and for the third year it will be R3. You have to find out the amount. Amount A, it will be P into 1 plus R1 upon 100 to the power N. Again 1 plus R2 upon 100 to the power N. Again 1 plus R3 upon 100 to the power N. This will be the formula for finding out the amount when the rate of interest for successive years are different. Means for 1 year it will be R1, for the second year it will be, the rate will be R2, and for the third year rate will be R3. Suppose R1 is 5%, R2 is 6%, R3 is 12%. Means what is going on changing? The rate is going on changing for the successive years. Successive years means 1, 2 and 3. The next topic is appreciation and depreciation. In the appreciation, when the value of an article increase with the passage of time, means as the time passes on, the value of that article will be increased. Suppose I purchase a land,
So on rupees 1 lakh, suppose I have I'm purchasing a land of with rupees 1 lakh, with the passage of time, means after 2 years, after 3 years, after 4 years, that the value of that land will be increased only. So that is the appreciation. That is an example for appreciation. And what is depreciation? Depreciation means when the value of an article decreases with the passage of time. Suppose I purchase a scooty and worth rupees 80,000. Okay, but after 2 years, will it be as same as the new scooty? No. So this is the condition when you have to find out the depreciation. When the value of an article decreases with the passage of time, the first one example I gave it for land, and the second example I gave it for your scooty. So with this, I finish all the formulas, and in this introduction lecture, what you have to do, note down all the formulas carefully, and if you have any doubt, you can ask me. Thank you for today.